It's time for the match game, Hollywood Squares, Hour with the stars of the NBC daytime dramas from another world, Christopher Rich, Lancie Frangione. From Search for Tomorrow, David Forsyth, Marcia McCabe. From Days of Our Lives, Leann Hunley. And the stars of the Mets game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Barman.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello there.
This is real silk. This Eisenhower-type jacket is made out of real silk. Yes. Feel that. Wow. Isn't that, doesn't that feel great?
Take
feel
it right out of Eisenhower's silk. Closet, feel too, wonderful. As a matter of fact.
Feel. Would you like to come down and feel his jacket?
No.
Yes,
like
I would. Can I?
No, I'm sorry, you can't.
No, but your wife yes.
He scares me. Goodness.
Now. Tell us, now... Another world. How many people have we had from another world?
Right here, Gene.
Most of our players are from another world.
How many people? No.
Just us.
Had Linda Day,
lonely too.
No, but we've had dozens. It seems like dozens. Yeah.
Scores, multitudes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
At least 10 or 12,
yeah,
I thought.
Any multitude. Yeah.
But this is your first shot, right?
Yes. And
yes.
But I'm not from another. I'm in another world, but I'm from Search for Tomorrow.
Search for Tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
Now, who directs your show?
Well, we have Ned Stark, who directs our show, and we have a bevy of guest directors who've been directing our show. We don't have except one under contract on our show.
But
now, we've got some good people directing our show.
Who's
some
that?
Excellent people. Well, we've got this guy. What's his name? Galtman or something? No. This woman's guy directs our show. His name is Chris Galtman, and he's really pretty bad. But, you know...
Chris, tell him to watch the show.
Chris
to watch.
Galtman.
Chris Galtman.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, yes.
See how long you're going to last.
All right. There, Chris.
Let's start the match game here with a brisk round of applause for our two players here, Joseph Malone and Maria Rasol.
Rasool.
Oh, very good.
Yes.
Hiya, Joseph.
Hi, Gene.
How are you?
Fine.
Good. Okay, that's the end of that interview. No, you want to say something about yourself?
Well, I grew up in Massachusetts. That's where my father's from.
What town?
Quincy, Massachusetts.
Quincy.
Mm-hmm.
Right. You can tell immediately everyone else says Quincy around the country,
Gene,
but the correct pronunciation is Quincy.
Right?
What's that?
That's near where we live.
That's right.
Right.
There you are familiar
you
with
Gene
my home stamping ground,
now?
Cape Cod, Osterville, Massachusetts. Right.
Right.
Quincy. And where do you live now?
Well, I lived in Honolulu just previous to moving to California. I lived there for 15 years.
What do you do, Joseph?
I work for a major insurance company.
Well, they move you around the
world. No. My mother's from Honolulu, so we moved back there.
Yeah.
And then my wife's from California, so we moved here.
I'm getting all mixed up, so we're just going to end the interview right there.
It's
but it's nice to have
fun.
You here, and we wish you luck anyway, Joseph. Maria, say your name for me.
Maria Rasool.
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 It's spelled S-O-U-L, and in my country
like
we say soul for S-O-U-L. But you say Rasool.
Mm-hmm.
What sort of name is that?
Well, that's Arabic, but...
Arabic.
Yes, but I'm Italian. That's
me. You are Italian.
Yes, I'm Italian.
An Italian Arab.
Actually, it's Sicilian.
Siciliana.
Siciliana.
Bella ragazza. What do you do, if
well,
anything?
Actually, I'm a single parent of two girls.
Mm-hmm.
I live in San Jose, and I work as a grocery checker.
All right.
I love to play tennis, and I love snorkeling and anything to do with the beach. I love being out by the beach, body surfing. It's great.
All right. Good luck here, Maria. Now, we're going to play the match game, and the winner will go on to... meet our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000 there. There's where the big dough is, but you got to get over this hurdle first. Let's begin with the first round. Joseph, you won the toss. You'll go first.
I'll try B, please.
All right. Let's see what B says. Norm said, the good news is I just bought the first TV with Smell-O-Vision. The bad news is they just showed a commercial for blank. Now, use your imaginations here in this round one question. Put it right in a slot there.
No.
All right. I guess we're about set. Chris is ready. Joseph? Norm said the good news is I just bought the first TV with Smell-O-Vision. The bad news is I just showed a commercial for blank. He's agonizing over this, as you can plainly see.
Perfume.
Oh! Joseph!
I hear it.
No, wait a minute. Now, you... I'm sorry that you misunderstood. You weren't listening. Here, the idea is, if you have a TV set in which you can smell the product being advertised, the bad news is they showed a commercial for something that would smell badly. Perfume is a pleasant smell. Am I making you feel bad, Joseph?
Definitely.
Well, I don't mean to do that. I just want you to get the hang of this game so we have a fair contest here. And hello, Leann.
Hello.
What have you got for him?
Joseph, I'm real sorry. I wanted to do this for Hawaii and everything, but I'm sorry, I said fish.
That's fish after the third day begin to smell bad. That's good. Chris?
Well, you know, when they show these commercials... Oh,
oh,
never mind. Okay. Garbage bags. You know, they show the garbage bags.
Yay!
Thank
you.
No, sorry.
No, see, now, you missed the point, too, just as he did. Garbage bags, per se, do not smell badly.
No, but the commercial for them, Gene, they show them with...
when they're all filled up.
Trash,
oh, they're
right.
Full of garbage.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Stick up for your rights.
I think this is a partisan audience here. Just because you're cute and young.
Thank you, Gene.
That's what I tell him every night, just because you're cute and young. All right, there's nothing worse than this smell, in my opinion, except for cat food, but dog food.
Well, dog food, yes. Yeah, as a matter of fact, some of them put deodorizers in it. All right, John.
Wow, I hope they like my answer, because then I'll know if I'm cute and young.
I can tell you right now.
Listen,
I said this.
You are young. But that's as far as I'll go.
I said this for all the people in Quincy and all the vampires out there. Garlic.
They just showed a commercial for garlic. That would smell badly. Right.
Okay.
Feeling older and homelier all the time.
Uglier all the time.
David?
Well.
Let's see, Dave.
Easy now. Kitty litter.
Kitty litter.
Oh, good.
Yeah, they like it. Oh, see.
Kitty,
you guys are controlling.
No, wait a minute. Hold everything.
Cool it, you guys.
You've got them too agitated.
Yeah.
The fact of the matter is, kitty, unused kitty litter does not smell bad.
Yeah, but see, the way the commercial works is some woman walks into your house.
That's true.
Obviously, you haven't seen the new kitty litter.
For recycled kitty litter.
Oh, I haven't seen that one. I don't want to see that one or smell that one. What have you got, Marcia?
Well, I'm sorry, Joseph, but I said... roach repellent.
Those roach really
roach smell. Repellent.
Oh.
Put it away, Marcia.
I don't think anybody got that question at all. Maria, let's see what we've got for you here. Grace said, I just found out how that plastic surgeon can give nose jobs so cheap.
Oh, tell me.
Instead of operating, he sticks your nose in a blank. Chris Gutman?
Gutman!
Gutman!
G-U-T-M-A-N?
No, G-O-U-T as in...
Now,
G-O-U-T.
I will not have you making fun of my fiancé.
How do you spell his name?
They've been engaged for something like two decades.
G-O-U-T-M-A-N.
How long have you been engaged to Chris Gutman?
I've been engaged for over a year. A year and 4 months.
What's the problem? Knowing Chris, I know the problem.
Yes, Nick.
Here we go. Maria.
Sorry, Chris.
Grace said, I just found out how that plastic surgeon can give nose jobs so cheap. Instead of operating, he sticks your nose in a blank.
Pencil sharpener.
Pencil sharpener is very good. I think it's quite good.
Ouch!
Isn't that a good one?
Good one.
Yes.
I wish,
You hadn't thought of that, huh?
Well, I had,
What have you got?
Well, first I said a vice, and I don't know how you spell it, so I crossed it out. Then I said
that's
a blender.
That's the correct spelling. Blender. Blender's good. Both of them were excellent.
Whoa. Well, that's quite a nose.
This is interesting because first I had a blender, then I said, no, you never get your face into the blender unless you had a really long nose. So I said the old meat grinder.
A meat grinder. All right. Yes, ma'am?
For a fellow Italian. I'm half Italian. Are you half Italian?
All Italian.
Little paisan. I'm sorry.
No.
All that, it's not the right answer. It's a...
Meat grinder. All right.
I wanted
so far,
to do it for you, but I couldn't.
We don't have a pencil sharpener, which is not a bad answer.
What's long and hooked and goes 100 miles an hour? My nose in a blender.
Right. Blender would have scored big here for you. All right, David.
Well, it would have scored very big. I put blender.
Right.
Oh, God.
One little pencil sharpener, Marcia.
Vice.
A vice.
Sorry.
All right, so there it is, round one. Zip to zip the score. Round two coming along right after this. We go with round two. Now, since the score is tied zip to zip, and he went first last time, Maria Rasul, you'll go first this time.
I'll pick B, please.
You want B?
Yeah.
All right. B it is. The Reverend said last Christmas Weird Willie produced a nativity scene. Instead of the three wise men, he had the three blanks bearing gifts. You got it already before I finished reading it. You got it. All right, Maria. The Reverend said last Christmas Weird Willie produced a nativity scene. Instead of the three wise men, he had the three blanks bearing gifts.
Three stooges.
Three stooges, says Maria. All right. Sounds good to me. Hello, Leann.
Hello, Gene.
Have you got the three stooges for her?
No, the three bears.
Three bears? Any trilogy is okay here.
Oh, no, isn't that a good answer,
yes,
though? Well, then why are you booing at me?
No, three stooges, three bears, they're all okay. Chris?
Let me put it this way.
Nyah, nyah, nyah. Whoop, whoop.
You got it. All right, one for her. Now let me see. Is that what is that what they do?
No, I don't know. It looks good.
Nyah, nyah, nyah.
Yeah, no, sorry.
Three blind mice. All right. There are more trilogy possibilities here than I had envisioned. I thought all six of you would say Three Stooges. John, what'd you say?
In honor of myself and the two other occupants of the lower tier, I said the Three Stooges.
All right. Are you one of them, David?
Well, no, not really. Well, perhaps. I don't know. But I thought he was a little bit kind. I put bears.
Three bears.
Aww. You really are one of them.
You're such a softie and a cutie.
Someone's been eating my porridge.
Okay. I said, in honor of the three morons on the lower tier, Stooges!
All right. Testimonial. So Maria moves forward with her second round question, and Joseph, let's see how you do with yours. The Hollywood producer said, I've decided to make a horror movie about my wife's cooking. I'm calling it Blank of the Meatloaf. All right, Joseph. The Hollywood producer said, I've decided to make a horror movie about my wife's cooking. I'm calling it Blank of the Meatloaf.
Horror of the Meatloaf.
Horror of the Meatloaf? Yeah.
Didn't say before.
Well. Oh, wait a minute. We do have another round to play, but I think you're a shoo-in, my dear. All right, Leann.
No idea.
What do you
those
say?
Words and the meatloaf.
Oh, boy, I'll tell you. Well, this is for when it really it gets back at you. The meatloaf bites back.
Revenge of the meatloaf. Very good,
yes.
Leann. Revenge of the meatloaf. Return of the meatloaf. All those.
It was a very dangerous meatloaf.
Attack of the meatloaf. Another good one. Got some good ones over here. What have you got?
It's a messy, messy thing.
The attack of the meatloaf. It just squished all over. Surrounded the whole town. All right, John.
But see, when we're dealing with food and the eating of such, the real solution is the return of the meatloaf.
Right.
This.
The monster comes back.
Gag me with a spoon.
David?
The real problem was the curse.
The curse of the meatloaf.
Curse of the meatloaf. We like that one, don't we?
Yes. Marcia.
The curse of the meatloaf.
So there's round two, 3-0, Maria's favor. Round three, the final round, right after this. Here we go, third and final round. Maria, you're ahead, you go first.
Go first? I'm going to go with B, please.
All right. Cheetah said. Does anybody do Cheetah? Do her voice? Yeah, you want to read Cheetah's voice?
Oh, I don't know how to talk.
Well, go talk
I went to Cheetah Tarzan.
Yeah.
Ooh. Is it Cheetah or Varan?
I'll do the narrative part,
do sound
and you
effects.
Do the stuff in quotes. Cheetah said.
I think the apes are mad at Tarzan. He just tied his blank.
They. Oh. You must learn to read, my dear. You're going to stay in show business.
Monkey's cameras.
This is true. Cheetah girl. They just tied his blank in a knot.
All right.
Wait.
Cheetah said, I think the apes are mad at Tarzan. They just tied his blank in a knot.
I'm glad to
anyway.
Play this around.
You might be helpful to him.
Very helpful.
What are you?
Yeah, good.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Yes, you can use that.
You got blank for it.
Oh. Cheetah said, I think the apes are mad at Tarzan. They just tied his blank in a knot.
His loincloth.
Loincloth is good, Maria. There are two good answers here, I think. Okay. Leann, do you have one of them?
I think I have the other one. Vine
and loincloth are the two good responses here. Nancy?
See, it's all that marinara sauce. Loincloth.
Loincloth.
There you go.
All right, she's got four. What do you say,
can't
David?
No,
vine. He has a vine. So she picks up one vine. More.
Really
and Joseph, this is your last shot at it. The best you could. Well, you could tie with four. You could win with five. Do not be discouraged here. Harriet, the harried housewife, said.
The hairy housewife?
Oh, Harriet.
Oh, excuse me.
The harried housewife.
The harried domestic engineer.
My enunciation is perfect.
The harried domestic engineer.
Right. She said, what a day. By mistake, I bathed the cockroaches and blanked the kids. A very hirsute.
Leann and I went to the same school.
All right, here we go. Joseph, put yours in the slot, Marcia.
Oh, sorry.
Harriet, the harried housewife, said, what a day. By mistake, I bathed the cockroaches and blanked the kids.
Sprayed.
Sprayed is good, Joseph. Ho, ho, ho. Now, you need four to tie and five to win. Leann.
Please. I'm going to milk this one because it's been so long since I've matched anybody. I
sprayed.
Swear.
Thank you. 4-1 the score. Uh-oh.
Well, I didn't. I didn't mean it. I said killed, you know?
Uh-huh. It's all right.
Whenever
Nancy.
I see a cockroach, I stomp on it, I crush it, and I kill it.
All right. So it's 4-1.
All right, New Yorkers.
All right, really? John.
Yeah, spray it. Don't spray
it. All right, 4-2. David, got to match them all down here.
Yeah, spray them, Carson.
4-3. One more for a tie.
I match you. You've got to promise to do a hula dance for me, okay?
Later.
Joseph, spray.
All right. Thank you. We have a tie, which means we go to the tie-breaking question. I will read it to you. Listen carefully. Blank store. Blank store, S-T-O-R-E. Now, in front of you here, but out of sight of the stars, are four pretty good responses to that question. And your seats were determined by lot. Maria, you're going to go first and ask you to choose a response by number only. Don't say any words here. Tell me which number you want there.
Four.
You want number four, so I will give that to you. Joseph, which one do you think is the best of the three remaining ones?
I like two.
You like number two. All right, I'm going to canvass the stars, get verbal responses from them. As soon as you hear your answer, please let me know. Leann, fill in that blank verbally. Blank store.
Grocery store?
Grocery store! She's got it! Congratulations! Right there on that spot! Wow! Hey, Joe, good luck to you. Nice to meet you. Joseph Malone going to send some gifts to you from the Match Game. Well, how do you feel? Goodbye to that. Now, here comes the rest of the set. We're going to switch to Hollywood Squares. John and I will trade places. Three more stars will appear here. Lots more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Venris Citation Super Thin Quartz Watches. Yellow gold tone case with black dial and jewel crown. Furnished by Venris Watch Company.
And now,
it's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Squares. Our wish from Days of Our Lives. Deidre Hall. Wayne Northrop. John DeLancie. taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bowman.
We'll be right back to play Hollywood Squares. Join us.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Square.
This is the part where they get to see your legs in the long shot.
Okay. Oh, I have my legs hanging out here.
Here she is, Maria Rasul. And actually, you're not even married anymore, right? To Rasul.
Right.
But you kept that name because your other name was?
Del Camaro. It was real long. Dulce Amaro means bittersweet, but I'm only the sweet part.
You certainly are, and you have sweet victory so far, my dear, in the match game. Let's see what happens in Hollywood Squares. We have three brand new celebrities. Wayne Northrop and a shoe. John DeLancie and Deidre Hall. I'm still going to talk to John. Sometime you'll explain that shoe to me. John DeLancie, and the character you play on Days of Our Lives. The character you play on Days of Our Lives, as typified by the set you've concocted for your square, is kind of wacko, isn't he?
Oh, yes, very wacko.
He's one of the most bizarre characters in daytime. And so is Chris
Anymore.
Rich. Not the character he plays, no, just him.
He's already got him.
Send me your shoes. You're tired.
Friends, Romans,
poor,
countrymen.
You're yearning to be walking.
Now, John's bootery. How about this guy that you play? Are you like him? He's nuts.
Am I like him?
He's just like him.
He is him. Isn't that strange? It's like,
yeah, I started out as a character who was supposed to be a psychopath, and after about 5 days, I decided that the show needed a little humor on the show, so we turned him over into kind of a humorous character, and he's been that way ever since.
Yeah, he's
kind of a funny killer.
He's very unusual and entertaining, really. And he's got a lot of left feet. Okay, it's great to have you guys with us, and it's good to have you here. Let's go play Hollywood Squares. Our defending champion.
There you go.
Why don't you just put that back on and send me a telegram, okay?
No, leave it out there, Arla. Come on.
Leave it up there, Arla.
Come on.
Her name.
Take it off.
All right, audience, take off.
Take it off, Arla.
Okay, now I'm going to. Okay. Let's start with this. We're a little bit behind on time. As we go into Hollywood Square. So I want to make sure we play enough game. But I will clear this up first. The very first day you came on this show, Arla Knauer, is now 5 days later. The first day she came on the show, she talked about delivering singing telegrams and strippograms. The truth is that you do not do strippograms. Is that correct?
I agree.
She agrees. Well, too bad, because you're going to lose all those squares now. Just want to clear that up, because it's potential.
This is it.
Right, because it is her fifth day on the show. That's as far as she's going to go. In Hollywood Squares, we will play this game until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point is our winner. Arla's been our winner for 4 days in a row, and so far has $30,925. She has gone on 4 times to play Supermatch. It can be worth up to $30,000. Our first game is worth $100, $25 for every square. Arla Knauer, your move.
Chris, please.
Chris Rich.
John.
Your doctor can tell if you have high blood pressure by looking into this part of your body.
Whoa, pal. Go ahead.
Calm down. You can do it. Go ahead.
I'm ready.
Does he look into your eyes or up your nose?
There you go.
I think he looks into your eye because of the pressure from the old optic nerve. Isn't that right, Dr. Rayburn?
Right. Exactly.
Absolutely correct.
Of course.
Indubitably, they agree.
Dr. Rayburn and I were just in consultation about that, and we agree.
Doctor, looks into your eyes, agree or disagree, to determine your high blood pressure.
I agree.
You do agree. Well, the doctor does, in fact, look into your eyes. You're perfectly right to agree. You get, in fact, the first square. Yes. Not up your nose. Maria Rasul, whatever game this is we're playing, why don't you pick a star?
Marcia, please.
Okay.
Okay, Maria.
Marcia McCabe.
Shoes on the other foot.
Did you get married yet, Marcia?
Shoes on the other foot.
Yes, I got married during the last commercial. Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Now that you're married, your dog is going into the hospital for 3 days.
Oh, no.
She didn't marry your dog.
She married our dog, actually.
Should you visit every day? Or should you avoid him because every time he sees you,
He'll think it's time to go home.
Oh.
I agree with the latter. I think that you should stay away from him until he's better, because that way it'll be easier for him to adjust.
Agree or disagree, Maria?
I agree.
You should avoid him. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get the square. It is the humane thing to do, and the humane thing for us to do is to break for a commercial and return and finish our $100 gag. See you then.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now back to John Bowman and the Hollywood Squares.
Okay, it's my left shoe, so that means you're in trouble, Maria, but you do have an O up on the board. Ollie, you're playing X, and it's your move.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Ready.
Which came first, Bugs Bunny or the first Playboy Bunny?
Oh, Bugs Bunny came long before the first Playboy Bunny, long before.
Agree or disagree?
I agree.
Bugs Bunny came first. You are right to agree, and you get the square. Bugs' official birth date, July 27, 1940. First Playboy Bunny in 1960. 20 years later. Maria, your move.
I'd like Deidre to block, please.
If you missed this one, the first game belongs to Arla. What does the Con Edison Conservation Service recommend you do to save on air conditioning bills? Should you keep your house as dark as possible during the day? Or should you walk around naked during the summer?
I think both would be effective, but I think probably priority is to keep your house very dark.
I agree.
She agrees. You should keep your house as dark as possible. Good play. You're right to agree, and you get the square, and you do block. So it is two X's and there's two O's, and you're playing X. Arla, make your move.
Nancy to block.
Okay, no fooling around.
The shoe, pardon the expression, is now on the other foot. You missed this one. Maria will win the game. Thanks, Nancy.
Yeah.
Nancy, your husband is unemployed.
Uh-oh.
I beg your pardon.
I just forgot to tell you about the new plot line, Chris. Right. Yeah.
Thanks.
Your husband is unemployed, but you work full-time.
Uh-huh.
According to the book American Couples, who is likely to do more housework, you or your husband?
Huh. Yeah, really. Unfortunately, I am still. See, a woman's work is never done.
She says the wife is still likely to do more housework. Agree or disagree, Arla?
I agree.
You, meaning the wife. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square, and you do.
Thank goodness.
All right, you are thwarted in that position, Maria Rasul, but it is your move.
I'd like Leann to block, please.
Right, the shoe goes over once again. You missed this one. Arla takes the first game and $100. Leann, according to NASA scientists, when will a drink make you drunkest? Morning, noon, or night?
Mm. Ooh, I suppose that has something to do with when you have something in your bloodstream.
Just what is it?
Whatever it would be, yes. What's that? Gin and two egg yolks? Something. I would say morning.
Okay. She says a drink will make you drunkest in the morning. Agree or disagree to block, Maria?
I agree.
A drink will make you drunkest in the morning. You are right to agree. You get the square. And you do block. And this is turning into excellent play. Right, just in time for the soaps. Arla, your move.
David, please.
Mm-hmm.
No, David.
David Forsyth for an X.
Here, Chris, punch in.
David, you're in prison in California and you've misbehaved.
Yes.
Again.
As punishment, could the warden force you to take a cold shower? Or is doing that against the law?
Certainly, he can tell you to do that.
He says the warden can force you to take a cold shower. What do you say, Arla?
I agree.
In California, it is against the law for the warden to force you to take a cold shower. I know, that's surprising to me. It's apparently cruel and unusual punishment. You should have disagreed, and your opponent gets an O in that place. So the plot thickens. We're going to find out what happens right after these messages. Return with us. For the challenger and 75 for the champ. Is she on the ropes? We will find out. Maria, you're playing O. Pick a star.
John, please.
Okay, now I will point out, you got four O's up there already. Five of any symbol wins a game, so if you get this one, you win. John DeLancie, you're a 22-year-old man.
Remember, John?
And you think of sex every other minute. According to a study reported by Dr. Joyce Brothers, are you normal? Or dangerously oversexed?
Literally every other minute? I'd say you're dangerously oversexed.
Agree or disagree, Maria?
I disagree.
According to a study reported by Dr. Joyce Brothers, you are normal. You are right to disagree. You get the square and you win the first game. So, 5-0's up there. Even more important, $225 up there. 75 for the champ, but there is still time. Sweep the X's and O's off of the board. We're going to start a $200 game, and Arlen Knauer, you are going to do it. Pick a star.
Chris, please.
Chris Rich.
John.
You just painted your living room blue.
Indeed, I did. Yes.
Can you put a little food coloring in the fish tank to make it match? Or will your guppies be goners?
I don't think it's a good idea to introduce chemicals to your water that you're taking through all those filters, so I'd say don't be putting that in the old fish tank, Letty.
Okay, he says don't put food coloring in your fish tank. Agree or disagree, Arla?
I disagree.
You can put food coloring in the tank. You're right to disagree, and you get the square. And you sure knew what you were talking about. You knew that one, didn't you?
No.
Oh. Well, silly me. Yes, you did. Maria Rasul, your move for an O.
Deidre, please.
Mm-hmm. Deidre Hall.
You know, it just comes from vegetables.
You're an insomniac, and you haven't slept for a whole month. Every night, you just lie on your back, staring at the ceiling. Should you see your doctor as soon as possible?
Have him come right over. Oh, no.
Or is your body getting all the rest it needs by just lying motionless?
No, there are degrees of sleep that you need. Resting is not enough, not good enough. Have your doctor come over.
See your doctor, she says. Agree or disagree? She says, see your doctor immediately.
I agree.
You should see your doctor immediately. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get the square. Good for you. Okay, Arla, you've got a little catching up to do. Pick a star for an X.
Wayne, please.
Wayne Northrop. Who is likely to have more moles on her body? A starlet or an older actress?
Moles?
Moles.
Research is.
Yeah. Well, I do know the answer to this because.
Well, tell us.
I have researched this before. Gene, we conferred on this. Actually, the older actress will have more moles on her body.
What do you say, Arla? Agree or disagree?
Oh, boy. I disagree.
A starlet will have more moles on her body. You've shown this for 5 days in a row. You're a very good player. Older folks have fewer moles. Good for you. You get the square, and Maria Rasul, it is your move.
Last time I listened to you, Gene.
It's your move for an O, Maria.
Marcia to black, please.
Okay, you missed this one.
What is that?
Arla takes the game and the lead.
The pressure's on.
Marcia McCabe, what do little girls learn to do first? Dress or undress?
Uh-huh.
Don't go by what you learned.
She hasn't learned to dress yet.
Yes, David dresses me every morning. No, I think it's a lot easier to take your clothes off than it is to put them on because, you know. So I would say.
Leave that right
now
there, guys.
It is,
thanks,
Marcia. Sure.
So
I'm telling Chris.
Undress.
The second row is smutty. Yes. Undress.
She says little girls learn to undress first for a very important block. Agree or disagree, Maria?
I agree.
Little girls learn to undress first. You are right to agree. You get the square, and you do block. Okay. That was pivotal for you, Arla, but it is your move. Pick a star for an X.
Nancy, to block. Okay.
You missed this one. It's a pretty big lead for Maria at this point in the day.
Anything.
Nancy Frangione, you're an average woman.
Uh-huh.
Who is more likely to be knock-kneed, you or your average husband?
Women are more likely.
Agree or disagree? She says women are more likely to be knock-kneed.
I agree.
To block, the woman is more likely to be knock-kneed. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square and you do block. So it's back to you, Maria. But time is up. She has done it. It really is back to you, Maria Rasul. $275, new champ. Congratulations. Maria has already zipped over to join you, Rayburn, because she couldn't stay in her seat for another second. Congratulations. Arla, we ran a little bit short on time today, but you know it was your fifth day. It would have been your last had you made it. You were, I'd say, one of our finest champs. Your total leaving here, $31,075.
You can buy a lot of truffles. Arla Knauer, congratulations. Gene?
Okay, John, here we are with a new champ. We'll be back with her and the stars for the big goal right after this.
And now, here to play the super matches, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you.
Okay.
I just met a girl named Maria. Here she is. She's the new champ. And we're going to have a go at the super match now where she could win up to $30,000. Shall we? Here we go. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. New York blank. $1,000 for the most popular answer. $500 for the second. $250 for the third. Any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance.
Marcia, please.
New York City.
New York City is hers.
Nancy, please.
New York Yankees.
All right.
And John.
Partisan audience. New York, New York.
New York, New York. New York City. New York Yankees. Those are the three that they've given you. You may choose one of those as the answer or think up one of your own.
I'm going to go with New York, New York.
New York, New York.
It's either that or city.
Yes. New York, New York. Yeah, a wonderful close. Town. Let's take a look at the $250 response, if you please. New York Yankees is there. All right.
Let's see.
That's one of the stars' answers. The $500 response says... New York, New York. John's answer.
I would have said
what do you think's on top, audience?
City.
City. They say city. Is it city? Slide it, please. New York City it is. All right, listen, you've got the $500. Now you're going to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision, the star will reveal the hidden number. We'll multiply the $500 by whatever number is revealed.
I'm going to go with Leann.
Leann, we hope she has the big 3-0. Ready, set, go.
Ooh,
$20,000. You're playing for $10,000. All right. 20 times 500, you're playing for $10,000. Good luck to you. Here it is, Leann. Blank. No help now. Blank up. U-P. Blank up or blank up. Leanne's ready, Maria. You collect the $10,000 simply by matching her. What do you say?
Look up.
Look up. That's a groaner as far as the audience is concerned. But we're going to find out now from Leann. She's the determining factor here. What do you say, Leann?
Oh, I'm, you know, close. Wake up.
Wake up.
I wanted to so bad.
Wake up.
That's an awful
Another good possibility would be 7-Up. That's a popular one.
Yeah.
There are a lot of good ones here. Well, you haven't done so badly. You're the champ now, and you'll be back next time, and you've got $775. We'll be back with her and the stars right after this. Here we are now. I know we're all anxious to know which of the stars on this final day of this
you
week
don't care anymore,
right? Soap opera stars had the big number. Would you all reveal them now, please?
Ha,
John!
Ha.
John
the
had it today.
Soapiest of them all.
Yeah. Well, listen, John and I would be very happy to see each and every one of you come back individually or collectively. Collect your shoes now. That's it, and get the right ones. John, you won't
wear shoes when you come back, okay?
Yeah.
Come
on, Delaney, you don't look too good in high heels.
Yay!
Hey, thank you very much.
We had a wonderful
Listen,
time.
Listen, yeah, you were all terrific. As far as she was concerned, she did well on her search for tomorrow, although it's going to be Monday.
It'll be Monday, right. You'll see us then?
I'll be back.
All right, I'm Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us on Monday.
John Bavin saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Square, Sarah. See you then. Good weekend.
A member of our studio audience will receive Montgomery Ward's coordinated 4.1 cubic foot compact refrigerator and microwave oven, a space-saving combination with microwave turntable and glide-out shelves in freezer, furnished by Montgomery Ward. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. are Mark Goodson, Television Productions.